I'm Daniel Yu, New York Chinese Temple Society. I'm the church rector. And this is going to be a very informal, not a structured kind of demonstration. So it's almost like an interaction. Of course, you know, interaction more like a little part. The first part of it, you know, we would like to demonstrate different aspects of picking up bread. And New York Chinese Temple Society actually has been in assistance for a little bit more than 4 years. Start from scratch, nothing. A group of volunteers, and just, you know, really, really interested in the field, and especially the Peking opera, which is representative of a Chinese opera. And we figured that the New York Chinese Opera Society can promote and bring the Peking opera to the communities, and particularly the students, you know, from college. And hopefully that, you know, we can promote Chinese culture to the extent, and also share, you know, some of the beauties of the performing arts, you know, in China. We basically have a group of maybe 10. We have 4 musicians here today, and 5 performers, and a group of 6, you know, I think, supporting personnel. Well, we include Mr. Xu, who's the chairperson of New York Chinese Opera Society at the back there. And also Mrs. Xu, she is the wife of our president, Mr. Qi Xu, who cannot, unfortunately, you know, participate today. I'm the treasurer, and we have Mr. Ho, who is director, you know, on our board. And also Mr. Moy, who is actually office manager. We are volunteers. We are supporting the profession, the musicians, performers, and of course we have Mrs. Yang, who is the makeup artist. And also we will have actually Mrs. Yang, who are all organizing and everything you see here over there, display. And then, you know, we will bring to you the process of makeup, and then we will, of course, you know, give you a chance to try on the costume, you know, when come. But in the interim, when they are doing the makeup, we can basically present certain Chinese instruments, and let you hear, you know, like say, you know, individual instruments, how they sound like, and with maybe some, you know, music, you know, a piece of music. And then after that, we will have the singing part, which is without acting, just singing. We have 3 performers for singing, and 4 representative of different roles. The Peking opera, that I know that you've probably learned quite a few from professor already in the past. But definitely this is on hand. You can call it behind the scene kind of work, but the real experience
is
and to explain
this one,
we have, you know, singing, and then in copy with storyline, which is, has a lot of Chinese virtues in there, such as, you know, royalty, chastity or righteousness, a lot of tradition, a lot of folklore. A lot of course of the historical, you know, dramas. So which is really very, very, particularly, you know, with the costume and the makeup. And you will see a beautiful, gracious, you know, movements. You will enjoy it. So I highly encourage you, especially every year in December, we have a 3-day performances, you know, at Pace University with different tastes of Peking opera. Some day we will have a whole complete opera, sometimes with just episodes, including one of the complete opera newly created by us, the story of Ruth. If you look at this, you know, perfectly, you have a program which is really the past December, the 3-day performance. There's a lot of information, a lot of the material there, you know, maybe you can go home and digest it. And then to see, you know, where the performer's coming from, what is their background, and what we put up. And then highly recommend come December you can watch out or look at our website www.nycosi.org, stand for New York Chinese Opera Society Inc., which is also in the program, and which has a lot of pictures, a lot of past performances, a lot of what we did in the past and what going coming events. So but the next most current coming events is due to be in actually April 30, Washington D.C. unfortunately. And we were invited to present the story of Ruth, the whole opera, which is in a way incorporate a lot of Western element into it, and not only the storyline. The plot of course is the Ruth, which is Bible story, but a lot of the Western elements. I heard comments that it's almost like off Broadway shows, which is just tremendous. We are very satisfied and very proud of our achievement because we are volunteers and we accomplished something. So today we have only maybe a small group to give you some of the tips. You look at the program, the stage, on stage, off stage, the whole team, almost like 80 people. 80 people organizing the event, with that, which is quite an achievement for volunteer or amateur, to put up. Of course, without the professionals, this is not possible. And the professionals, they have their work, their daily work, So they are sacrificing their time, and they have to rehearse, and they have to really perform for the love of the performing arts. I would like to thank them. But without further ado, first session of it is going to be the makeup. And I want to pass to Mrs. Xu, and who will basically monitor that makeup process, and Ms. Yang Ling, who is the performer we call her Hua Dan, one of the role young lady and young lady role, and she's going to do the makeup, and Mr. Wang Hong, and he is in the role of Chao. Chao is a slave. Okay. Later on, they're going to perform. Okay, so not only singing, they're also going to perform two pieces, okay, separately. But now they're going to do the makeup. So there's going to be a makeup process. Mr. Chi is going to explain something. When they are doing it, when they're into it, then we can start to introduce the music part of it. And they're doing their thing. And then we're going to be spreading the music. So now let's start with the makeup process. And they're doing their own. Every actress, they are trained. But we do need a makeup artist also, for certain other aspects. Okay, Mrs. Chi.
Michelle asked me to help her out because when she's doing makeup, she cannot talk. So I don't know much about Afro neither. So I'm learning with you. And I hope we all learn something today. If you have questions later, you can also ask later. And Michelle is doing her makeup. She put on the foundation, that's the base. And then usually the color, she told us already, is red, black, and white. And now it's very convenient. We come in the tube like the foundation. So she's putting on the foundation right now. And it takes a little while. Usually in my performance, it takes 2 hours for her to put on the makeup and also put on the headpieces and all the ornaments on there, her hair. So we can see Mr. Wang Hong is also putting on his makeup too. So we can see them, they're working hard and tapping their face. I guess that is a good massage too, to start with that. That would warm up.
But it's a different color, just because I'm the girl, and he just,
okay. Well, for Mr. Wang Hong, he's because he has portraying a different characters, so he wants to draw the audience to his face more. So the color is deeper, more in the red. And the ladies is a little different. It's a more pastel, I guess, in the beginning, and the color builds up layer after layers. I also had an experience on somebody, makeup artist put on the makeup on myself. So I kind of know how it feels. And it took more than 2 hours.
Yeah, that's the first thing. And second step, so red.
That's the red.
Uh-huh. And I just use.
Okay, now she's putting on her red on her cheeks and her eyebrows.
Yeah.
Yes. It's very dramatic, the colors. You can see that it's very deep. It's a beautiful red. And I guess you're going to notice that when she put on this very dramatic red on her eyes, I'm sure there's a purpose. I think that the color draws the audience attention from her cheek, because she will put it on her cheeks too. From her cheeks draws the attention to her eyes. Because in the Beijing opera, the eye movement is very important, and it conveys, her eyes conveys her inner feelings with the audience, and it shows her feelings or maybe what's her plan, and it, from her eyes we can tell. So maybe later we can all pay attention to the opera singer's eyes and see what we can learn from them.
As far as the color is concerned, colors, you know, always mean something. And one of the things that you heard about the painted faces, the mask is mostly for those qin. There's four rows, row of, you know, characters. First is the ladies, you know, which is done. And the sun is for the gentlemen. And then qin is for mostly the painted face. We call it painted face. Today, unfortunately, we're not going to have a demonstration of painted face, or how they make up the painted face, which is a long process. However, if you look at the program, page 24, three rows of pictures, and the middle row, the second from the middle row down, 24, I think, right, is it? Right.
Yes.
And then that is the painted face, and that is in red, you see. And then there's red signify like righteous, you know, brave, and courage. And then black signifies honesty, integrity. White is no good. Okay, white is normally, you know, not for, you know, the guy who's, you know, really very, you know, mischievous, you know, a lot of no good stuff for the bad characters.
And selfish
too, right? And then the yellow, and then the green, and the purple. So they all signify certain characteristic of the person who's at or the role. So color, you know, when Mr. Chu mentioned color, and then you might want to take notice of that. Now, the dark, the female role, and the sun, the mirror, those normally do not have elaborate, you know, makeups, okay? Because they want to show their natural kind of like feature or the facial feature. The only other role which has some makeup is the chow. The chow, you see sometimes someone, you know, up there with a patch of the white, you know, around the nose. Those are chow clans, you know. So, but nevertheless, the painter face is the one who has elaborate face marks or makeup.
So we can see the intense color spilling up now from Mr. Huang, who is putting on the makeup besides on his face, and now it goes up to his head. Well, most of the upper troop, they have their own makeup artist. And we have Yang Laozi, who is a professional makeup artist. But all the professional performers, they also train to do their own makeup because they do travel a lot. Sometimes they cannot have a artist with them, a makeup artist with them. So they can all do their own makeup. And it's amazing when I watch them to do all this beautiful fine art on their face. I hope that one day you can come to visit it backstage and see how they work. And they do it really fast too.
And the step three, we just use the powder to make the oil paint to stay.
Okay, that's the powder. Okay.
This also have to put very, very thick.
Again, it's layers like painting. You have to put layers after layers of coloring on her face. Yes.
Now use the brush to take off some powder.
Try this at home, buy some makeup and work on it and see how it will come out.
Thank you.
any other Western operas, do they do makeups like that?
Not that happening,
right? Yeah. Well, what I learned just recently that in the beginning, long time ago, when they started Chinese opera, in the beginning they used mask, like a lot of Western opera. But after they perform, they feel that because they cannot show off their feelings, their facial expression, so using a mask is not as good. So they decide to paint it on their face. So that's how they start with the painting on their face.
And do you know why? I have got a question. Do you know why is the makeup such a thick?
Why is
I just explained one. And how about second? What do you guys think about?
Why it has to apply a heavy makeup on them? Do you know why? Take a guess.
Mm-hmm.
Does it sweat off?
not exactly.
That's a good answer. Okay, any other? Go ahead.
Because the bright lights can really wash it out if it's not too.
That's right, yes.
Uh-huh. And what else?
So it'd be more elastic and see.
Yes, that's true. But what else?
There are many other reasons you can think of too.
It signifies aspects of their character, sort of the different colors and everything. That it demonstrates, you know, tells the audience who this character is and what their traits are.
Yes, that is more applied to the male. Most of the female are the similar color, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, that's a very good answer. Yes.
And I just give it. Think about the Peking Opera. Just start very long time ago, like 20?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Almost.
And also the makeup, maybe older than that.
Yeah,
think about that.
Mm-hmm. I would just guess that 100 or 200 years ago a lot of the pigments used to make up were more natural.
Yes.
And maybe like earth derived or plant derived, and so more would be needed to create a brighter hue.
Mm.
Also, the Chinese woman, the traditional is, you know, women cannot do anything outside, just stay home and maybe cooking, do some housework. And then they cannot go outside to play a role in the stage. So,
that's good, that's good, cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes. Very
yes.
Good answer. Yes.
Later on, we're going to politically about this, you know, cross gender or impersonating, you know, like. But in the beginning, of course, you know, the women are forbidden, of course, you know, to be outside, particularly in performing. So the female role is actually performed by the male actors, and of course, you know, they have you know, devised a way of singing. And also a lot of, but you'd be surprised, you know, I heard or in the rap, you know, sometimes men are more like women. they notice, they observe, you know, the characteristic of women, so they exaggerate it. So in some extent, you know, they are really developed that kind of, you know. But then later on, of course, all the female roles starting, you know, females take over, so then, more, you know, Sheldon that a gentleman will act as a female nowadays. But on the other hand, as it developed, you know, the beginning of this, you know, century or so, there are, well, maybe 1930 or something, you know, there are women, actually female actress, you know, who impersonate a male role. So, today, later on, we're going to showcase, actually not showcase, I'm sorry, we're going to kind of, you know, let you experience how you feel like with a male singing as a female and a female singing as a male. And we incorporate that into the singing style. Of course, you know, this is only singing, not a performing. But the performing, you know, I mean, every movement, you know, a female, even though it's a male, is really more female.
and vice versa.
Now we can see that Michelle and Hong is also, both of them are doing their eye makeup now. You can see that it's the eye makeup is very heavy, it's very dramatic and put a very, very wide lines on it. The purpose is to pull the eye up, look up, make it bigger too. And also you can see Huang has the face has a little white edge in the front, and that already identifies his role in the theater.
Okay, while they're doing theirs, and I'm going to move on to the music or the orchestra. And the orchestra actually is really, you know, you can separate it into two sections. One is the strings, woodwinds, brass, you know, instrument. Oh. And then, is it any better? Probably the same, right? But nevertheless, I try to raise my voice, you know. I'm sorry. But the second segment is really percussion. And there are more, the first, you know, kind of, you know, type of the music. But then there's less in percussion, but percussion is very important. The strings are mostly for melodies, for singings, and then emotions, showing all that. And the percussion is mostly for the acting, performance, movements, and every move is almost, you can hear the drum, you know, or the clapper, basically signifying every movement, you know, right at the right time. Now, the drum or the percussion is mostly keeping track of the rhythm, the beat, controlling the sound, and melody, of course, is very important, which is, you know, mostly emotion, mostly with the singing. So the drummer is actually, sometimes we can call it like the conductor or the leader of the band, because, you know, he's the one in control. Okay, but the violin, you know, the part of the so-called jingbu, the string instrument, is very important, because a lot of singings, you know, you really have to master, and actually with the actor or actress, you know, otherwise, you know, you can't pull out the emotions. And so we're going to, right now we have only four musicians with us. If you look at the page 5, and there's the orchestra section, and if you count, which I did, you can almost count 20 instruments. But normally, actually for a small scale, you don't really need all 20. Most important that we call the so-called big three, in the string instrument end of it, three instruments very important. Jingwu, Erwu, Sanxian, plus the Yuexin, and I will explain those, you know, and show those. And then later on, of course, you know, I'm gonna show the percussion part of it with the drummer, with the clapper, and the cymbal, and the conch, with the conch, and basically this, maybe four major type of instruments, but we have only one in the drama who can, you know, show you all those four. I am going to introduce to you Mr. Wu Liang, who is the jinghu, and he can also play one of the instrument, which is called bit. The jinghu is a string instrument with two strings only two strings, and with a bow made up, the strings made up with silk, and the bows made up with a horsehair, normally, okay? And then with just, you know, two strings and a bow, he's supposed to master all the melody and the tune and the singing and a relatively high pitch. And it's bamboo make up, and the highest of that bamboo stick, you know, basically control the sound because the resonance is at the bottom, which basically earwood is a little bit taller, so we have a lower pitch, and then zhongwu is a lot, you know, much longer, then we have a more, you know, let's say, again, like almost close to the base end of it. And Mr. Wenliang can show you the jinghu, and this is what we refer to, the length and the resonance, the box, sound box, and the bow, the draw, and the two string, silk string. And so Mr. Wenliang is going to show you some of the sound. Instrument. home, you know. So there's, as you see in page 5, there's quite a few of the different instruments that we are not showing today. But those are the main pieces in the Chinese speaking opera. With those pieces, you can almost like perform, you know, any opera episodes, singing part. And of course, Mr. Huang. Mr. Huang is the drummer today. And with him, he has this cracker, cracker. Right, he has a drum. The small gun is when the female, you know, actress, you know, first appear on the stage, you know, as an introduction. And the big, of course, is for the male actress. You know, jazz element into it that, you know, depends on the actress. Sometimes when you sing it, there's variation of it, different, you know, so-called style device from that. So there's a lot of freedom, a lot of creativity, so which is different from the set piece. That they are in a simple way to explain, you know, the picking operas, the kind of music kind of it. And nowadays there are some, you know, say Western instrument being introduced. Sometimes you see the big scale production, there may be a symphony of the orchestra backing up here. but that's not really normal, that's not necessary, but that's sometimes accurate. And Mrs. Chu, you know, can explain certain things about the makeup now?
Okay, as usual, lady usually takes longer to put on the makeup than men get ready, right? Okay, so this is a good example. Anyway, I think we can see the difference between the two makeups, right? Look at her eyes, just pay attention. What's the shape of her eyes? Her eyeliners, let's say, you curve what? Up, right? And look at Hong's, it is the kind of down, right? Can you think of an animal that the eyes? What do you think? A very famous animal, lovable, that is from China.
Panda.
A panda, right? Panda, right? So we can tell his character is adorable, right? And it's, so that it portrays a really fun and adorable, a lovable character. And then Michelle's eyeliners, it goes up. Think about an animal. What do you think?
Fox.
Yes, go ahead. Very good.
Fox.
Fox.
Yeah.
Perfect. Yeah, fox. So we can tell her character is what? What kind of character a fox has?
A beautiful character.
A sneaky, yes. Really, maybe a flexible, yes. Very well, in the way the fox is very smart too, in the way he's charming, in the way.
Fox honey.
Yeah, foxy, right? So she's very charming. So we can tell that, all right? So anything you would like to? So now we can see Hans has a the white patch, they call it tofu kuai, those are like a tofu, you know, like a tofu square. Yeah, that is
the crown, one of the four main roles.
Yeah, so when you see it, that little white patch, that means is the character of a crown. Okay, the three dots on top of his forehead, that means he's a monk.
A monk, accolade, actually, portray later on.
Portray a monk.
Trying to sneak out of the temple and go back to the human society.
Yeah. Well, this monk is a young monk that is with the three dots in my
book.
How many dots? Okay, so he only has three dots. That means he's only just a beginner into the, what do you call that, into the
Buddhist,
what do you call the temple. So the higher ranking, the older monk, they have more dots. The maximum is 9. So pay attention. If you go out, you see 9, that means they are very high up. Okay.
Those are actually scars, you know, a ritual that, you know, the body is just about food, that when you trying to get into the religion, and Catholic with different levels, you know. So he is actually only a student, in a sense. And which, you know, every time, you know, with those, you know, burning, you know, incense, you know, to burn into a special kind of ritual to have that. And then the more, meaning the senior.
Okay. Now we're going to go back to Michelle. What Yang Lao Si is doing is doing a lei tou, they call a lei tou, for Michelle. So the reason she's doing, you can see that she's pulling all this ribbons and to tie her hair. And to actually, the purpose of doing that is a facelift, okay? So pull her eyebrow up, so it would, in that way, she would look very energetic and looks younger and also more charming. It's very tight because I had the experience, and it hurts actually if you wear for a long time. So we should really appreciate that actors and actors when they are performing for 2 hours and with that type of, you were really uncomfortable feeling with them. But for art, they do a lot of, they really work hard for us. So now you can see that her face looks different now from a while ago. So there are many layers of tapes and binding.
This one can protect my eye nuts,
to protect her eye so you won't, that the eyebrow is always up, not falling down.
The beginners, you know, sometimes, you know, with a long, the effect of it, you know, you sometimes you feel so uncomfortable, you almost like want to throw up. But you get used to it eventually. But there's a really high, you know, kind of, you know, sacrifice, I think.
Okay, now you can see this is actually part of her head piece or the hair. This is supposed to be real hair.
Yeah, that's
the real hair. And now the gluey thing is it's from the elm tree, probably the elm tree bark. And they put this bark like this one, like this is, okay. The shaving of the elm tree bark and soak it in the water for 10 minutes. So it turned to be very sticky. Okay, so this would put on this hair piece and go through the hair piece. And we stick on her head, and it's all natural, so it's a good thing that they use the natural ingredient for the material for their hair. So you can see that it's piece by piece. Oh, okay. you can have a feel of this. Take a look.
This is better than the Elmer's glue.
And it stays for many hours too, you can see. Yeah, right? So we learned something new today. Right? But when you try some, you don't feel sticky anymore, right? Yeah, isn't that just
yeah,
a very clean feeling,
clean.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's not like a lot of other
adhesive
stuff.
So probably it's really good for your scalp.
Like,
your skin is good for your skin. Oh, actually it's very clean. You don't even have to wipe it. Right? It's dry stuff and you feel very clean. It's more like the, what do you call it? Aloe vera, when you apply it to your hand, it's sticky, but once it's dry, you don't feel it,
right?
Because it's natural, so we can
see that it smells
good.
So it's
an
addition that I had this week.
Okay. Clean feeling. won't feel sticky anymore.
It's almost like less than five, I think, artists like Teacher Yang here who can do that. But she is the foremost, she's number one. So every single performance we need to have, you know, Mrs. Yang. But if she's not available, there are backups, but not too many. Yeah, I can count five. In New York.
The assembly is just really crucial.
Okay, now. Absolutely.
Yes. Right.
Okay, now you can see that there's a piece of ribbon or cloth cover her ears on both sides. The reason is that in the Chinese tradition, ladies cannot show their ears, so they have to cover it, so she would
be more ladylike.
So every time there's a performance, you know, we normally arrive maybe 2 hours early, just because, you know, number one, for this pickup. Number two, of course, there's a lot of, you know, behind the scene preparatory, and then with, you know, costumes and also all these costumes, you know, really there are people who iron it, so make it, you know, more presentable, and then arranging everything. After the performance, of course, there's another 2 hours. Dismantling everything, right? But everything before we actually put our performance, there are specialists who assemble all that's necessary, because it depends on what kind of opera show, what role is there, what kind of costumes required, what kind of plot is required, even though the plot, you know, on stage is normally a bear. You know, you go to the Peking opera, normally it's almost like a bear stage. Not too many sceneries. Nowadays there's a little bit change, but no scenery, because you don't want to be distracted. You just, you know, use your imagination, and then you know where the actors or where the actions is taking place, which is a special kind of, you know, characteristic of Peking opera. But because of the stage is so brilliant, also, the makeup and the costume, they are very colorful. They stand out. But you imagine, you know, if you had the background, all these trees, flowers, you know, the actor, actress do not stand out as much. Earlier I talked about the four kind of roles. First role, son, which is a gentleman role, which has, you know, a normal, like, depends on age. Or the elderly one or the more mature one, you see all this beard, and then you have all the long beard. And if it's bright, black, you know, younger. And if it's white, of course, gray, white, you know that, you know, it's older. And without any beard, that is a so-called a young gentleman, okay? Which actually is a different role, but it still belongs to the son. The young gentleman sings a different voice. And then the elderly gentlemen mostly are scholars, officials, and those are mostly usually the main actor. And then the son, under the son is Dan. Dan, which is the female role, which has, you know, huaga, qing yi, depends on their, also lao dan. Other than the dan is the jing, which I show you the pink face, and then the fourth one is the chou. The chou, the clan, is the one who can use a lot of colloquial, you know, kind of, you know, speech, or you can almost like improvise, can put in anything there, to make it interesting. And sometimes, you know, in a piece, even though it's a historical piece, the clown in there could say, oh, welcome to New York, you know, put it in there, you know. That make, you know, it's more the Shakespearean, you know, clown in a sense, because the role is very important.
Oh, actually, I just noticed my scar, okay? You can see a lot of different designs on that with the different Laosun, right? You can see all different center, different characters in each opera. So, see, different really beautiful fine art. So that different ones. Right? I don't know, is this upside down?
Oh, yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
It doesn't help.
better?
Yes, yes, yes. They're all different, but different characters in different operas. Yeah. So each one is different. So you can tell that, you know, different.
Later on, we're going to have, you know, singing part of it. Three performers going to sing. First, Mr. Chan's going to sing A Pink Face. In essence, you know, his character is really a legendary judge during the Song Dynasty, which is almost like 1200, I think, AD, around that area, that time period. Legendary in the sense this judge is very righteous, and you know, he's mainly to help the poor. And Mr. Chan is going to sing that, and his character normally painted in black. And after that piece, it's going to be Miss Margaret. Miss Margaret's son, she's going to sing a historical character. Go back to almost like 500 or maybe 600 AD, historical drama. And then going to sing by Mr. Lu. Mr. Lu is really a folklore kind of a history, actually, history, historical. Also, going back to the Qin Dynasty, which is the early Qin, the turn of the, I think it's around maybe 220-something BC, okay, a lady. So Mr. Liu is going to sing a lady. A lady who is the daughter of a high official who wants to marry her off as a concubine to the king. Of course, you know, she rebelled. But other than those three pieces, singing, then followed by the performing by Mr. Wang Hong, and then Aman, you know, as I said earlier, you know, want to really escape from the temple, and then there are the performing piece by Miss Michelle. Michelle will be like a young lady, and notice when she perform, you should, you know, pay attention to a lot of the movements and what exactly she's doing, because it's very stylish, very conventional, and very basically open to your imagination. That you have to fun hit her, adding you know what she's doing, and which is particularly difficult. As Mrs. Chu mentioned before, the eye movement, the hand movement, you know, all signify different things. Okay? There's a door there, she opened the door, how did she open the door, you know, that kind of thing. And then she's going to do some kind of how she is performing a young lady who's doing the needlework, which is very, very interesting, particularly with the music.
Now her makeup is ready, right? Yeah, it's ready. Look at the color screen on her face. It's a magic color. Yeah. After I have a cousin, actually, who cannot, you know, have a big movement because the head is very heavy and it's very tight. Also, you can see that.
Okay. Now we're going to perform the singing part of it. Mr. Jan Junchun, like I said, you know, he's going to sing as the Jing. All three different kind of singing, you see they are all different. Different pitch, different kind of, you know, like emotions.
Thank you.
page 24 look like a red face. All right. So.
So as a red face, so this guy is courage. He's, you know, courageous, and he's a general, and he's basically in the kind of a war, kind of, you know, warring state.
Miss Song,
going to
sing for us.
Okay. Margaret is going to sing as a Lao Shan. Margaret, you look at page 24, the middle row, the first one, you know, if she's acting, you know, on the stage, she will be like this, the top one, okay? And Margaret.
Thank you.
now the next, Mr. Leo is going to sing as a female role. And if you look at page 23, the top one will be more or less like, you know, what she's, you know, basically the character will be more or less like that.
Thank you.
tropes are important. Different pieces, different tempo, different beat, different rhythm. And all depends on the opera itself. Don't be afraid though, of course, you know, you don't understand what they're doing, what they're singing, of course. But if you come to any of our performance, we have the screen basically projected with Chinese and English translation. So you know every single piece that they're singing, they're speaking, which is the more interesting when you follow the storyline. And advice, if you can, if you go into any of the Chinese speaking opera, try to find out what piece that they are performing. Do some study, read a little bit of the background before you go. But if you don't make time for that, you go there, we always have, you know, basically a synopsis. So a brief understanding, and then you watch what's going on the stage, and you look at the screen, you know, the projected screen, and that's a lot different. It's very interesting and very, very different if you know the storylines also. Okay. Now, so next will be the performing piece. Will be Mr. Wang Ho. Ling Xian and Yang Xian. Okay. Yang
Xian.
Okay, so
ladies first. Okay, before I start my performing, I just have some movement and show you, and you just guys know what to do, okay? Like that.
Embroidery, right? you know, also a salmon, okay? And later on, Michel will come back again, show the so-called water sea and certain other, you know, movements, okay? And one more. And you notice there's carpet. And of course, the carpet is not really pressed into the wood at the stage. And in our performance, a big piece of carpet, and they're all fastened. So that, you know, because you know, there's a lot of the martial art element, a lot of acrobatics, so you need to have, you know, kind of some cushion or carpet, and also, you know, to prevent accident, they should be all fastened down. In this case, it's not fastened down. Maybe more difficult for him, but he's going to perform a part of the so-called escaping from the temple.
Two,
That is very good. And also add our step, just like that. Yeah, that's called hua bang. Okay, just from side to side. Okay, very good. So we add two.
It's a piece of wood, actually, you know, a latch into the hole, yeah? So you slide out.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So we got half out, and close to the top.
Thank you. Ah. 好，进了，欢迎。好，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来，来， Thank you.
for you some decomposition of the movement. So if you want to record your own movement, this is the time to learn.
Just let Mr. Wong
actually turning one channel. It's actually a lot of this movement similar to the Tai Chi. And earlier there's, you know, Yun Shou, which is the sort of cloud in there. So the movement of your hand signifies the cloud, you know, in the sky. This is signified the big eagle or big, you know, bird, you know, in the sky turning.
Sorry?
The kind of training they've had to act. Yes, yes, that's right. strenuous training, usually 18 hours a day maybe, when they're young, in the old, particularly in the old style. Now, of course, there's an opera school in mainland China, not here, and they go to school the normal. On top of the academic classes, they have to learn all these different kind of, movement, singing. All depends on, the teacher will say, okay, you're suitable for this role, you're suitable for that role, and sometimes because of your vocal, ability. Vocal ability is very important. Whether you make you really a major, actor or actress, is singing ability. And other than that, before that, I think the gentleman there first.
For the that I noticed, a lot of
Other
theaters
especially Tai Chi and Tai Chi. Not only that, usually they have to be more knowledgeable in the Chinese calligraphy and the painting and with the arts, with the movement. And a lot of dancing, this is really, I guess, universal, more or less. You mentioned about ballet and all that. Not strictly they're learning ballet, but then movement in common, sometimes. But they definitely have to learn a lot of dancing, a lot of the body, how to make use of the body. And then you have it.
What determines who plays a man or male or female character? Is it just vocal ability, or because I noticed that there was a man playing a woman and then a woman playing a man, and
A man playing a woman, or the gender thing, is no longer normal or usual.
Okay.
Okay. Now it's more natural. So falling to the natural role. So if you're a man, you play a man. And if you're a woman, you play a woman. But it doesn't mean that you cannot restrict it. In a sense, there certainly if a lady are more man oriented in the sense of thinking that he can achieve in a sense, or more suitable for that. Of course, she can do that, but of course, it's more difficult. Natural is more easier. But in the past, it's because of the culture, because of the social restriction, you have this cross gender thing. But as to what kind of role, young gentleman male or elderly gentleman male, it's different because the singing voice is different. A young guy sings more or less like a woman, using a falsetto voice. Okay? So singing is very important ability that to determine whether this person should play this role. And then will be determined by the performance. Any question? Okay, now the December performers is scheduled to be December, first week of December, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and it's going to be a page, and it's going to be announced later on in our website, and please watch out on the website. As a special of the class, you are interested, when the time comes, you should are welcome to email us, and then we'll offer a big discount specifically for this group, and make available a better seat, so to speak, and then please just come. And you will have an entirely memorable experience, okay? And of course, we are a non-profit organization, so any really donation will help what we're doing, for the ongoing future. But basically, just keep in touch and be interested and look at the website, okay? Anything?
Come here.
By the way, Facebook profile picture.
That's what Austin says.
It's like profile.
Okay. I'll put them on.